Hello. It's 10:40 p.m. I think, and I've just had my evening herbs here. Brought a bunch of plants in preparation for expected frost. About to have my salad for dinner. You may hear the laundry that I'm doing. Certainly, obviously, taking a shower and just in the robe. And you can see them editing and uploading some videos. Right now, Renee's video to YouTube. A few more that we've done. I'm sitting here on the couch, which maybe you can see. And behind me are some seeds, some drying seeds, some milkweed and money plant seeds, and papyrus, and so forth. And I guess a mirror on both sides here. So, I'm kind of settled in for the evening, and for a variety of reasons. Kind of thinking about the aspects of self. There's the self, the self that's born, which is the self we tend to think of. I think that's because we're thinking of it from the unborn self. So to think of the self is to think or feel or consider, contemplate from the unborn, and considering or addressing oneself to the born, for example, the physical. But another way I've come to think of this is that there's the complete self addressing the incomplete, which of course is all the rest. I'm noticing that there's like a reflection in my glasses here. I'm looking at you. So I think maybe I'll take them off for this. Thinking maybe it's distracting. Yeah, I think you're likely to hear the laundry going now. So, there you have that. So there's the complete addressing itself to the incomplete. There's the whole addressing itself to the fractionated. And so I have this sort of intellectual understanding or theorization of that. My one of many suppositions that we carry, at least for some time. So what I want to do is settle into a meditative position. I probably can't really tell, but I'm just sitting in my kind of cross-legged way on my lap. Not on my lap, making a lap of the cross-leggedness. I was sitting earlier here, sort of swastikasana, but a little bit more of a padmasana now. The unbalanced washer clearly doesn't meditate, so it's drying now, but it shakes things. So it probably sounds, maybe feels as if it sounds different now. Again, there you have it. So, I'm going to sit in meditation, having taken my herbs, about to eat the salad, in the middle of editing and uploading, laundry going, seeds behind, plants indoors, about to enjoy the last few minutes of wakefulness. In my own domestic life here, after a day filled with students and work. So I want to consider all the parts of myself, but see if I can't develop a meta-awareness whilst considering the fractionated self, the partial self, the born self. Let's see if I can't come to an awareness of who, what it is that is doing that considering what who is doing the addressing, what who is aware at all of the self that is indeed born fractured, fractionated, fractal. Divisible. So what I'm doing is I'm scanning the aspects of the self. Could be literally body parts, body regions. I can come in to sense of those things by the actions that are born of those parts of the self, the parts of the body self, or involve them, or are catalyzed by them. So for example, I can check in with the breath to become aware of the lungs, or the abdomen, or the diaphragm, or the rib cage. For example, I can become aware of the heartbeat to help me get a sense of the circulatory system, or the pulse, or the heart, or the pericardium, for example. But it doesn't have to be the body self or its parts. It can be a facet of my psyche. It can be the memory stores. While I become aware or address my unborn self to the born self, or some part thereof, or area thereof, or activity therein, or thereof, or thereby, I'm trying to be aware of the source of awareness, or at least the direction from which that awareness flows. So while a light bulb is on, you may not be able to see it because of the light coming out. It can be aware because of the light, the direction of the light bulb. You can become aware of that. And so if I can't quite see the unborn, the whole self, pondering the unwhole self, I may ascertain a direction. I want to say that's heavy. Really, the feeling was light and sing, but heavy in the groovy man sense, but describing the sense light. So if heavy had its own intonation, we could say light with the intonation of heavy. Maybe light, heavy, weight. Weight, light, heavy, I don't know. I'm kind of giddy. Anyway, I thought we were going to do that for a few more minutes, but... well, that seems to have worked or done something. I hope you feel good. Thank you. Warming the sleep walk.